In this screencast, we're going to look at an herbicide spill over a field. And the fluid remains on the soil for 10 minutes before being depleted both into the air and into the soil. And we need to find the differential equations that govern both of these processes, as well as stating the initial and boundary conditions needed to solve the problem. So let's set our coordinate system, where positive z is going to be in the upward direction. So this is an example of an unsteady state diffusion problem. How do we know? Because the fluid is being depleted both into the air and into the soil. It's not an instantaneous process, so the concentration of herbicide is going to change with respect to time. So our plan for both situations is the same. The first thing we're going to do is simplify the continuity equation. And in this particular case, we're going to start with the equation in Cartesian coordinates. The next thing we'll do is, because the continuity equation is in terms of the flux, or N, we're going to simplify Fick's law so that we can find this flux. And we're going to call it N sub A, where A will be the herbicide. Next, that expression that we got for N sub A, we're going to substitute it into the continuity equation. And what this allows us to do is state the continuity equation in terms of the concentration of A instead of in terms of the flux. Then we're going to find appropriate initial and boundary conditions for both of these processes. So let's start with the first situation, which is the mass transfer into the air. And we are going to assume that this is stagnant air. Let's look at the continuity equation. So that's the change in concentration of A with respect to T, plus this divergence of our flux, and that's going to equal our reaction term. So this divergence term looks at the flux in all directions, the X, the Y, and the Z. So the first term stays in because the concentration of the herbicide does change with time. Since the mass transfer is only in the Z direction, that will simplify to the flux in the DZ direction with respect to Z. And finally, there is no reaction in our system, so that becomes zero. So now what we have to do is we have to find an expression for this flux in terms of our concentration. So that leads us to Fick's law that says that the flux in the Z direction is equal to negative the bulk concentration times the diffusion coefficient times the change of the mole fraction of the herbicide with respect to Z, plus, and now this part is what's considered the convective part of Fick's law. So this Y sub A times the N sub A plus N sub B. N sub A is the flux of A into the air, and N sub B is the flux of air into the herbicide. And this is going to equal zero. We have stagnant air. So now we can write this as minus C D AB DYA DZ plus Y sub A times N sub A. Now let's write it in terms only of this flux. In other words, let's gather our terms for this flux. And this is going to equal minus C DAB DYA DZ. However, it asks for this in terms of the concentration of A. So we take the definition of the mole fraction. It says that it is equal to the concentration of A divided by the total concentration. So now this can be written as minus dAb divided by 1 over C sub A over C. And this entire thing is multiplied by dCa dZ. Now that we have that, let's go back here to our continuity equation. And what we're going to do is take what we just calculated and substitute it into this. So now dC sub A dt plus d dz, and here comes our substitution, equals zero. So in order to solve this, we have one term in terms of time, but then we have these two terms in terms of z. So we're going to have to find one initial condition and two boundary conditions. So first of all, remember our coordinate system says that positive z is in the upward direction. In addition, we'll say that t is going to equal zero after 10 minutes. The reason for that is that the fluid stays on the soil for 10 minutes before depletion begins. So now we can put these together. The first is the initial condition. And what it says is at t equals zero, and so for any z greater than zero, in other words, above the field, the concentration equals zero. We then have two boundary conditions. One is at any t greater than zero, we look at the surface of the soil and say that the concentration of A is whatever the surface concentration is. And finally, at t greater than zero, as z goes to infinity, RCA is eventually going to become zero. So our diffusion into the soil is similar. We start with the same continuity equation. However, Fick's law is going to change because you can assume that there's no convection in a solid. So we start with dCa dt plus dNa sub z over dz equals zero. But now our Na is going to equal minus c d sub ab dya dz. And the reason for that is this term y sub a, Na plus Nb is going to equal zero. So again, we're going to write our flux in terms of our concentration, and that's minus the diffusion coefficient dCa dZ. And now when we put it into our continuity equation, what we come out with is the concentration of the herbicide with respect to T minus this diffusion coefficient D squared C sub A over DZ squared equals zero. So again, we need an initial condition and two boundary conditions. The conditions are going to be the same as before, only in the opposite direction. The herbicide is going into the soil. It's going in the downward z direction. So our initial condition is going to say at t equals zero, remember that's after 10 minutes, and any z less than zero, we're going to have no concentration of the herbicide. Our boundary conditions are such that any t greater than zero at z equals zero, C sub A equals our surface concentration. And that's one of the boundary conditions from our previous situation. Finally, at t greater than zero and as z approaches minus infinity, remember we're going in the downward z direction, now our c sub a equals zero. So between these differential equations and initial conditions and boundary conditions, it is possible to solve for the concentration of A. And in this last situation, this is what's known as a semi-infinite medium. In other words, there is only one definable surface, and it goes to infinity in the rest of the directions. And soil is usually modeled as a semi-infinite medium. And often the solutions include what's known as the error function.